So now that you've seen a little bit of how to deal with sterile technique and you've set up your sterile tray, if you've already set it up for a particular procedure, which is either going to be the cap change or the dressing change, the next thing that you would need to do is put on your sterile gloves. Your hands have been washed, your mask is on, your tray is set up. We have already cleaned the table, so the surface has been cleaned with alcohol and it's ready to put your sterile gloves on. Again, we have contents that are sterile on the inside, and they do give you flaps in order to open it. And here, even though the outside of this packaging was sterile, it is now contaminated with my hands, but it doesn't matter because the inside is still sterile. You'll note that they give you edges with which to open up and expose the gloves. I find it best if you fold the folds backwards on themselves so that you have better control over the packaging. And the same with this. So again, you never touch the inside. If you contaminate there, your gloves as they're shifting around are also going to pick up that contamination. So you only handle it by the edges that they give you. They also are kind enough to tell you left and right, and your hands will go into them in this manner. And a little pinch on the inside here usually helps to control that. Do not put your hands here because the tendency of this packaging is to fold back down on itself, in which case it will contaminate your gloves. It doesn't matter which hand you start with. It doesn't matter if you're right or left-handed. You just do whatever is comfortable. But what you will have to do is put each glove on in a slightly different fashion. So what you're going to do is pick up the glove near the cuff. You'll note that I'm not touching any of the packaging, and while this might look like I'm contaminating the glove, this part ends up against my skin, which, of course, we know now is contaminated. Lift the glove up, come away from the surface that you're using so that you're in the free air and you're not likely to hit the edge of something which will immediately contaminate your gloves. If you can locate where the thumb is, and again, I remind you that they are put in the packaging like this, you slide your fingers in, try to locate the thumb, which is here, and the rest of your fingers tend to naturally fall into place. I am allowed to grip up to here because that's what comes down on my arm. I have one sterile glove on. I'm not allowed now to touch anything unless it is sterile. So I can't, for example, touch it with my other hand, but I can touch this glove because it's sterile too. This glove, I cannot pick up like this because the likelihood of contaminating as I'm pulling it on is very high. So instead what I do, and I'm allowed to support the outside of this if I need to, I'm going to tuck all four fingers under like this. I'm going to get my thumb out of the way. Spread my fingers to give the cuff a little bit of stability. And again, I'm going to find the thumb. And the other fingers, again, keeping my thumb out of the way, and the other fingers tend to find their way into their respective slots. I have two sterile gloves on. I'm really not allowed to touch much of anything. I could get rid of that, and then my tray would either have to be presented to me or it would have been left here ready for the procedure. But the correct positioning of your hands after you have sterile gloves on is in front of you, so you remember that they're sterile. So you don't put them down by your sides because the first thing you're probably going to do is, you know, touch your pants or something. So you hold them together in front of you to remind you that they're sterile, ready for the procedure.